our previous episode of the Homes and Construction Show, we had an introduction about lighting. By the way, do you know that you can have a 5-star hotel brought right away in your home? It is very simple. We looked at the magic, which is lighting. So today we are continuing with our topic about light, but we need to know what is the difference between the lights that we can have at the kitchen from the lights that we can have maybe in our backyard gardens. With me today, I have an expert, and for the ones that maybe missed her in our first episode, don't worry, because we still have her. And let us welcome her to our show as she introduces herself to you, our viewers. In our previous episode, I noticed that you were in a living room.
Yes.
And I identified that we had different types of lights. Today, we are on a different set. We're in a dining, but I'm seeing the different lights. So I need to know, does a place matter really? Why aren't we having the cinema kind of light here in a dining?
You remember in our first episode, mm-hmm. we talked about the tasks, that you light your room according to the tasks that you're going to do in that mm-hmm. room. Now, in the dining room, you're not going to watch a movie. No, mm-hmm. you're only going to, actually most of the time you use it only to eat.
To serve.
Either tea mm-hmm. or food. Now, how do you light your dining? Now, in this particular dining, we have three specific lights, types of lights.
Mm, which ones are those?
We have a centerpiece.
True.
And in the dining, you make sure that you have a dropping centerpiece. Why?
Mm.
The dining must have a lot of light that you're able to see everything just like you are in the day.
Mm.
It's where you put dropping lights. Why? To be able to see everything. For instance, you're eating mm. fish. You are in position to see that you can identify all the bones in the fish.
Mm.
Even if it is meat and maybe the soup has bones, you're able to identify the bones. We do not want to get any accident that comes as a result of eating something because you did not see it. It might be, and sometimes you know how the food can be cooked and maybe it has a hair or something mm. like that. But that light should be in position to show you everything before you eat it.
Mm. Then to give you give you that satisfaction.
Yes, that what you're eating is okay, is good. Then you can have a strip light in your mm. dining. Why? The times you're just taking a cup of tea, you really don't need that too much light. You just need something that makes you know, it soothes you while you're there, and you're able to take your tea. So those are the different. Then we have that window those days.
Mm.
It was one of the fashions, but it is now outdated. But we had already put it there. So at that time when it was there, we asked ourselves, how do we make it come to the trend?
True.
When you look at that stone, you might think that it was designed there. No, we only had to become
more creative.
And we put a stone, and then we put the decorative lights. Those are what they call decorative lights.
Mm.
You're not going to use those lights at all, at any one time, really, that you're going to see something.
Mm.
But they will look beautiful. The minute you look at it, it has a design, it has a stone, automatically it will give you a good feeling.
Mm.
So sometimes lighting is not per se that you have to use it to see. Sometimes it is just about beauty. How beautiful does it bring out the things that you have in your home? How can you creatively use it to make it, to make the place look ambient?
Because I'm looking at the door, okay, the window.
Yes.
And right after the window, there is light.
Yes.
To me, I'd be, okay, if it were for me, I would say that is enough light. So I wouldn't need this other artificial light, since the positioning is perfect for the natural light to come in. But
no, just, yeah, it is. Just imagine the curtains are closed. You won't be able to get the natural light. And just look at those two pieces out there. First and foremost, even if I switch them off, they would glitter. What does it mean? They would look nice. Now, when you look at them, when you switch them on, they have a design, which is already adding to the original beauty that it had when it is off. Actually, in the digital world of lighting, we look at beauty first, and then the additional beauty that comes after the light is lit. Your light should be able to say a lot when it is off. Now, when it is on, it should say more than what it said when it was off. Actually, when we talk about digital and analog, what does it mean?
Because for us in the media, we understand it differently.
Exactly.
That, okay, those days, the analog, you know, those kind of TV sets that had these weird shapes, but now we have different. So analog in media, we understand it differently. So I didn't know that it actually applies also
in the lighting world.
Yeah,
it does. Actually, for you to know that you're still in the analog world of lighting, you still have a lamp holder and a bulb.
Yes,
that is what it means. And that when I enter into your house like this, the only thing I'm seeing is a lamp holder and a bulb. No, in the digital world, we use equipment. Actually, when I enter into your house, we are able to see the equipment. We won't even know about the bulb. The bulb is inside there. But what we see on top is an equipment. Now, apart from that, in the digital world, we don't use one concept of lighting. We might use strips, we might use spotlights, we might use the centerpiece, which is the equipment, big equipment. It's either dropping or sitting on the ceiling. So it's those different types of equipment that shows that now you've moved to the digital world of lighting.
That means you can have all equipment in one space.
You can have a number of equipment. Now, I'll give you an example, like in the sitting room.
Yes.
Maybe we will go back to the sitting room or bedrooms now here. There's so many people, while they are building their houses, they would leave the walls. You see the wall? Blank. That is also part of the analog world, where you had a full wall blank. Today, we make sure that we design what they call wall brackets for our sitting rooms. In where the wall, you don't leave the wall empty, because this wall bracket adds some beauty to that wall.
Very, very true.
Yeah. So those are some of the things that will really show that now this person really understands lighting, because then you will know that I want my wall bracket centered here, and then it will be there. I want this one centered here. You don't put too much. Yeah, I want actually our viewers to know that too much of anything is bad. Even if you're putting wall brackets, at least make sure that there are either two walls here and there.
Not then having on top everything of that,
not everywhere.
Cluttered.
Yeah, you don't clutter the place with every, you know, too much of everything is bad, really. Then if in case there are walls that you would want your pictures to be, then instead of putting wall brackets, then put picture lights. Now, those are some of the things that are showing us this person has now moved
From the analog.
Now this person is in the digital world. There are other lights that we've not talked about, like the table lamps, the floor lamps. All those will show us and will tell us, especially the floor lamp will tell us so much about you. It's very executive people who really have floor lamps in their homes.
You see, the reason as to why we are having you today on the show is because we are going to talk about all those details.
Yes.
Because I wouldn't want to have to go to someone, my friend's place, I find a floor lamp maybe as a spotlight, being used as a spotlight on a wall. You see that?
Yeah.
So that is why the Homes and Construction Show is here, because we want our people out there that don't know about specific decorum of how to do certain things should learn from us. We come out with the experts, and we're glad you're here.
Thank you.
Now, let us look at the budget. At what point, because everything is about planning.
Exactly.
So when do I start to plan on a budget of my lighting?
Now, you remember when I told you that when you're designing your home, you have visualized.
Yes.
Now, when you visualize, you now know, this is what I want. Now, at that time, you'll be able to go to the market and say, how much is a strip? How much is this? How much is that? Now, much as you're visualizing the kind of lighting you want, now you even have a picture of how much these lights cost. The kind of light you're going to buy from the European market is not going to be the type of light you're going to buy from maybe the Asian market or maybe China. Any of those countries. So you're going to look at our lights from a point of view that they are quality, extreme quality. So it also depends on someone. First, there are people who will say, me, much as the European light is expensive, but I want quality. And then there's this person who will say, me, as long as I have light, it's okay.
That's it. Yeah. I don't care if it is.
There you leave the person to be.
From which market or which market.
Exactly. You leave the person to be. You know, sometimes quality is expensive, but it is worthwhile. You're not going to buy it over and over again.
Now, that is where our problem is most of the times. You see, when they say, you have the analog ones because they are going to have a bulb, a lamp holder, a bulb, because they feel that is more affordable compared to the high end kind of equipment. But now let us look at someone who has a low budget but want to really live big.
Yeah.
How would you advise them?
Hilda, I believe that everything that we do in our lives, we have to be intentional. If you want something, you will intentionally work for it. You might not bring in that high-end thing. Obviously, in the lights, there are lights that are not high-end. The only thing is that you won't get maybe that very beautiful or very good of very quality, but we always have a budget for everyone. That's one thing I believe. And we intentionally do some of the things that you make sure that this is the kind of light I want, you will work for it. And I still will give you examples of clients who will come, and every other day this client will come and ask you, how much is this? And then you say 750. Most of our pendants actually fall around there. But why do they fall around there? They have very heavy glass, they are very beautiful. You're not going to find them anywhere. I have visualized my budget is going to be like 6 million.
On lighting. Now,
Only lighting. Lighting is actually expensive. Good quality lighting is expensive. I can tell. But you can decide and you say, every other month, out of my budget, I'll be putting maybe 200,000. That is while you're beginning to build. By the time you complete the building, you might find that I have maybe 6 million of yours already. And already lighting becomes cheap. It is only expensive if you want to do it all at once at that very time. No, there you will feel it. You will feel their pockets, by the way. Yeah. One of the things that, especially those ones who did not have a plan, it's very demoralizing, by the way. Now, I'll give you like a scenario where one would want to have strip lighting. One of the things I would tell you that for us to have strip lighting, we shall need to do the gypsum boards. At least either we will use a barricade. A barricade is where we just build the boards on the sides. Or at that time, actually, if we tell you that we are going to use the barricade, it now depends on the height of your ceiling. Now, we would want to do that, but when it is not possible, why? Because the height is too low, that the minute we add on something, then either they will be knocking on somebody's head or some, you know, things like those ones. So that is why it is always important to visualize the kind of lighting at that time when the architecture, in that we are given the necessary heights that we need to be able to achieve the kind of lighting styles that we would want to have in our homes. Yeah.
So putting all that aside, what are the specific places that must not miss out on lighting when you look at a whole home?
Now, it also depends. I'll tell you that I would love to see my bedroom the best. Why? Because I spend most of the time there. Then there are people who, for them, it's about the sitting room. So it also depends on the taste of someone. But I would tell you, the sitting room will tell everybody about you. Every visitor who comes to you, it will tell them about you. The way you do it, the way you've designed it, the way you make it up, will talk so much about you. So it is very important that you make it right. You make your lighting right in your sitting room. Make your lighting right in your dining room. Then there are places I will talk about, like the corridors,
exactly,
the kitchens, the bathrooms. In those corridors, in the kitchen and in the bathroom, every light that you put there, it must be able to come out as day. You see the way you see your day out there?
Yes.
It's the way the same, the corridors, the bathrooms, and the kitchen should be.
The bathroom, why? Corridors, kitchen.
Yes.
Should have that light.
That daylight.
That very bright light.
Very bright light. It should be like you're outside when it's not at night. Why?
Exactly. We need to know why.
Because these are the places that we do a lot of activities. For instance, the corridor. Just imagine water poured in the corridor.
Terrible.
And you came and you are passing. You slide.
Disaster.
And fall. And you don't know what kind of accident that one might come out to be. Then in the bathrooms, just imagine you're in your bathroom and you're not able to see that water. You'll still slide. And that is another accident. In the kitchen, we do a lot of activities in the kitchen. You might find that you're going to cook at night. And you need the cutting of the onions, you need the cutting of the tomatoes, you need then able to see everything as you're doing it. You really need daylight. You need that light to be very bright, in that you're able to see everything that you're doing then in there. So those particular areas should be cautioned to have daylight. I'll give you scenarios of when you buy equipment, we need to look, if it's not a full LED built equipment, then you should be in position to know the different bulbs that we put in the equipment. There is
I get the equipment, then I have to buy the bulb.
In some of the equipment. There are equipments which are full, complete LED, in that you won't need any bulb. But then there are equipments where you will need to buy bulbs.
Now, in this case, if I came to you and I got those imported from Germany, what? Then I'm using some, okay, the equipment I'm getting, I'm buying the one that was imported from Germany. And
the bulb
is something that
you buy from the market.
From the market, and yeah, you don't know the supplier.
It is still okay.
Won't we face a problem of dysfunctioning?
No, you won't. Mm. You won't. The only difference is when you're still buying bulbs. Now I'll tell you that there are bulbs. There's warm light bulb. There's a cool light bulb. Then there's the light bulb.
Warm light does what?
Now, warm light is very silent. It's one of those type of lights that makes you feel, I don't know whether you've seen these homes out there, and then when the light comes out, it's more like yellow.
Mm.
That is warm light. It gives an ambience. Oh my God, and you won't like to leave or to stare at that building if it's lit. Then there is cool light. It's not so much day, it's not too much, but it's not, it is in between day and warm, but silently in its own way.
Mm.
Then there is daylight. Daylight is that is, you're able to have the same light as it is day when it is during the day. Like that light would be able to surface like day in the night. You get me?
You have it, but when you enter a room,
you might think it's during the day.
Because this happens, I think, most of the times when you enter office spaces.
Exactly.
You are in a mall, you don't know that it is already night.
Exactly. That is what it brings out. That is daylight. But now, for us, in most scenarios, we just go and you buy a bulb.
Mm.
No. You should know, where does warm lighting work?
Mm.
Where does cool lighting work? Where does day lighting work? In the kitchen, if you're using equipment, please ensure you put day bulbs.
Mm.
In the sitting room, it's okay to put warm light. Apart from the centerpiece, where you would need to read, you can still mix.
Mm.
Because at no one time are you going to use these lights at the same time.
True.
No. When you're taking a cup of tea, maybe you're using the decorative lights. You can put in the warm light, the warm bulbs.
Mm.
Yeah. At that time, you will not use the daylight. Now, at the time when you're going to read, yes, use the centerpiece. It will have daylight in that you're going to be able to read, and you'll be able to see everything that you're reading.
Mm.
Yeah.
Remember, lights don't only create beauty of your home, but they add value in cases when you want to maybe put it on market. And you should always be mindful of the colors. Mind you, the price is manageable. You can always look out for the professionals. Avoid the quacks so that we all have a better Uganda to live in. Thank you so much for being with us. This is the Homes and Construction Show. And my name is Hilda Kamkama. Until next time, may God bless you.